Welcome to VidPenguin 2. This is the preliminary demo for the beta version that's currently out. So I'm going to grab a video, but you start with the dashboard, and it's kind of arranged the same as RSS Masher. So I'm going to go into Video Ping, and I'm going to sort by the last ping. This is, you could sort, you could do a filter, anything that you want inside this dashboard. If it's completed, it will say yes, and you can turn it off and on down here with your control panel. So let's start with a brand new one. I'm going to hit add, and I'm going to go grab just a YouTube URL. Actually, here's one right here. Thumbnail Blaster Review and Bonuses. I did this over a year ago, but let's just take a look at it. I'm going to cut the seconds off. Or you could just grab it down here if you wanted. That's easier for you. Come over here, paste the URL in there. We have a built-in spinner, which is using Spin Rewriter in the beta version. We also have a built-in link processor, so you don't need to add any integrations. But the integrations that you'll have to put in yourself are any WordPress.coms you have, your bloggers, your Twitters, your Tumblrs. And we integrate with Integromat and Zapier. And we also have Amazon AWS set up, which is a great way to index your video pages and your images. And we're also linked in with Flickr. So I'm going to start off by spinning both the title and description. Okay. And it brings the tags across, also your thumbnail. And it brings across an image. Now this is very similar to what you've seen in the original VidPenguin, but here's where it's different, is you can add thumbnails if you're going to create social content. If you're just sending out the links like you did in VidPenguin 1, VidPenguin 2 is real easy. You could just skip right over that. I'm not going to send any image packs. Hit update, create the variations. And we use the 32 YouTube approved variations. And it's not going to show a thumbnail. It will show the thumbnail from the original source. So we're going to skip that. We're going to go down here and move to the integrations tab. Now, to do the original VidPenguin, you just hit your link processor. Come down here to update. Move to the ping tab. And I'm going to put, if it's going to link processor, I'm just going to send them all at once, and I hit update. And then I just freeze and ping. That's all there is to running VidPenguin 2 to duplicate exactly what was on VidPenguin 1. Okay, now let me show you the power of VidPenguin 2 and why we went in and built it from scratch. I'm going to come over here to Video Ping, and I'm going to sort by reverse order here. So that's what I just sent out. Now I sent it out to link processor, all 32 variations, same as we did on VidPenguin 1, but now I'm going to go in and clone it. And I'm going to come up here and take this new version that hasn't been run, it hasn't been pinged yet, and I'm going to do something different with it. So I still have my title, and let's take that spin off of Blaster. And I'll do the same down here because it is a trademark name, so I want to take that off. And I think that's all there is in there. So now I'm going to come in, I hit update. Now here's where it gets fun. Is I'm going to use image packs. Now it takes our tags inside of YouTube and puts them in here. And I could actually pull from Pixabay if I wanted to. But sometimes with a very brand oriented, it's not going to pull very good images from Pixabay. So I'm going to use an image pack, and I just email list building. This is, come down here to content marketing, just as an example. And I'm just going to randomly, I think there's 100 images in this pack. And I picked it up over here under image packs. I'm going to add the EXIF. And what that does is it puts the YouTube URL and the title of the YouTube inside the EXIF of the JPEG, giving you more link juice inside of image pings. And I'm just going to do an image pack. I'm going to do an image replacement, hit update, create the variations. Now you should see the thumbnail images, and they all are 1280 by 720. And we just in this view here, they're squared up, and we're going to fix this in the final version. They'll show it 16 by 9. Okay, so I'm ready to go from here. Now I can generate an RSS feed if I wanted to right here. And I could add it before the description or after the description. And this is a nice little feature if you want to toss it into RSS Masher, or if you got a use for your RSS feed, which you could put it into FeedBurner. You can export it to CSV. But I'm going to move to the integrations. Now this is the real power of VidPenguin 2. I'm going to go out to WordPress. I'm going to send variations. I think I only have one WordPress. Yeah, I've only got one WordPress in there right now. And I'm going to send, four variations. And it's going to be a link post with a video embed. And let's put it in a category of video SEO. Okay, now I'm going to go to Blogger. And I think I've got a few bloggers in here, so let's see. Oops. Video Leads Machine, I'll add that blog. And Spin Picks, I'll add that one. And let's put it definitely in VidPenguin. Okay, so I'm going to send 6 variations, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to evenly space them. So it's going to send 2 to here, 2 to here, 2 to here. And now, this is what your Amazon bucket is for. I'm going to do VidPenguin. And let's just put it under images. Do the same here. So what we're doing is we're storing the thumbnail images inside of VidPenguin, inside the Amazon bucket, so that Blogger can pull straight from the Amazon. Now, what it does is it builds some backlinks for you back to your AWS. And so now I'm going to go down to Twitter, send it to a few of my Twitter accounts here, and let's do maybe 3. Let's send it to Damon. I'm going to send it to Oscar Cameron. If you've been part of RSS Masher, you've seen Oscar Cameron grow. What that means is original content. So let's put it, let's do Caveman Plans. That should be enough. So I got 4 Twitter accounts. So I'm going to send it 8 times. Actually, I'll send it 12. So that means I'm going to evenly spread them out, and it's going to send the title and the link 3 different times to all 3 of these, which evenly means it's going to send 12 variations out. Now let's do Tumblr also. Very similar to Blogger. I'm going to send a video embed post with the backlink, and let's send it to VidEP, to that blog. I'm also going to send it to @webdesigns. I think I've got multiples in here. Let's send it to Where It Art also. And Amazing Hamburger. These are my test accounts anyway. So I'm going to send 4. So I'm just going to do 4 variations, meaning 1 for each of these 4, because I'm going to spread it out evenly. Now, if I said all, that means I want to send 4 variations to this one, 4 to this one, 4 to this one. Instead, by evenly spreading them out, I'm going to do 1, 1, and 1 to equal 4. Okay? And I'm going to skip IntegraMAT and Zapier for now. And I'm going to go ahead and put it to the private blogger network. Now, this is still under development, and we've got a little over 100 different sites that we're going to be adding. So I'm just going to send it in here as a sample, and I'll just put it under stock investing. I'll come back and delete it later. And then finally, HTML embed. I'm going to send it to Amazon, and I'm going to actually create a video page that I can post elsewhere. So let's go to VidPenguin, select folder under videos, and just to see a preview of what it's going to look like. So we'll have the video here, watch on YouTube, which is the clickable link. You'll have your description, your thumbnail, and a subtitle. So that's what it's going to look like, and I'm going to hit update. Okay, so I'm ready to go to the ping tab. Now, here is the power of it, is I want to spread it out over 30 days, my promotion campaign for this, and I'm just going to drip feed it. So I'm going to hit update, and it's going to schedule out all those integrations. So on August 5th, it's going to go to WordPress, August 6th, Blogger, August 7th, Twitter, August 8th, Tumblr. So you can kind of see how it's going in there. I've already done link processor, and once the links come back, once it's been posted, we send those links of WordPress and Blogger out to link processor also. Now, this is the button right here. Once you hit freeze and ping, it goes to town and starts working immediately. So I'll hit freeze and ping right here. I am done. I've completely done that video. Now, let's go back. I'll show you a really cool trick. What I'm going to do is I'm going to save this setup as templates. So I'm going to hit save as template, and I'm going to call it VidPenguin integrations, used for VidPenguin channel. This is the description just for myself. Now, what I've created is in a template that I can use to quickly do this anytime I want. Now, let's go back to thumbnails. Okay, so we did all the integrations. We got some thumbnails in there, and it's highlighted. So I'm going to come down here, and I'm going to send to image ping. This is a new feature. I don't think anybody's doing this. Is what we're doing is we're putting EXIF data behind all the content with our image URLs, with a spun title, spun description, that we're using from the video pane, and I'm going to hit update. Move to select images. And I'm going to use that contact. I'm going to put the EXIF in the thumbnails themselves, so I'm going to hit update. Update variations. Now, this is the URL, this is the title, and the tags are all going to go inside of this image, and it's going to be placed inside of Amazon, AWS servers, and Flickr. So I'm going to hit move to integrations tab, and I'm going to turn on Amazon, and I'm going to go ahead and send this to, let's go ahead and send it back to VidPenguin, select a folder, and I'm going to use just a different folder, images, video thumbnails. Here we go. That's a great one to use. Send to link processor. So it's going to pick up these URL links and send them to link processor for you. Go to Flickr, and I'm going to send it to my Flickr account. Well, I haven't set up my album yet. So I think it just sends it to the main album. Actually, I need to integrate that. So anyway, you would put in your Flickr account here, your album, and then it will update. So I'm going to just turn this one off right now. Now I'll hit update. Move to ping tab. Now, I'm going to spread these out over about a 30-day period. Hit update. And so for the next 30 days, all those images, there's going to be a total of 49 images going across. And what it does is pulls every image out of that image pack that I gave to it, which it looks like there were 49 of them. And it will put in this EXIF information, which will be the URL, the video title, the video description, and the tags inside of the image itself as EXIF. Hit freeze and ping, and we're done. So what we've done in less than 10 well, less than 10 minutes because I've been talking this whole time, is we did a video ping. We indexed it just like we normally would do all the variations. And then we went back and put in all the social integrations. And then we sent all the thumbnails out as image ping. Now, let me show you. We have image packs. And right now, we sell them, but we're going to be, we've got about six of them in here you could add for free. And you can just kind of see what they look like if you want to take a look at one of them. You could see the image pack itself. A lot of good content in there. And then copy this thumbnail pack to my account. When you do that, now it's already been copied. When you do that, it adds it in to your own image packs. Now, here's the neat thing. If you have a video and you want to make a dozen or more different thumbnails, put them in a folder and just add that folder in there. Kind of like I did here with, and I made these myself, 1234 address. This is for a real estate company. So that's how you make an image pack. Very easy to use to create your own image packs right there. And our fact, it tells what we've done on version updates. So occasionally you're gonna see this change and you can come in and see what we've done. And then we have some other questions. So once you click the freeze and ping, what happens if you have a mistake? Well, here's what you do. You just highlight it and change the active status. So it turns it off, so it doesn't continue to send things out. If it's already been freeze and ping, that means it's already out. The database has locked it down. So the only thing you can do is clone it or turn it off if you don't want to send it anymore. So that's all there is to VidPenguin 2. There is a lot of power here to build out an incredible backlinking network through social networks, through your integration sets. And when you tag in Zapier, you got 1,000 integrations you could send that video embed, title, and description out to. Same with IntegraMap. So we don't limit, you know, which you could use either one of them. Very easy to set up. So anyway, if there's any questions, just drop them in the group, and I appreciate you sitting in on this very quick demo. Bye-bye.